In this time of desperation.
Hello, I'm Sam C, and I'm here to bring you the message Nehemiah, Prayer Warrior. Prayer is when we communicate with God. We can be intimidated when others pray because they seem to be masters at praying. However, prayer, whether big or small, as long as it comes from the heart, is important. Nehemiah was a prophet in the Old Testament. He was cupbearer to the king Artaxerxes I of Persia around 465 to 424 BC. This prophet, however, is known for his prayers. It wasn't the length that made them great prayers, but instead how often he did them and the reason of them. Here are the three aspects of Nehemiah's prayers that made them great. The first thing we can learn from Nehemiah is that not all of his prayers were long in length. We've all been there, the person who prays for 20 minutes while you're hungry. Now, I'm in no way saying that long prayers are bad. As long as it's from your heart and helps build your relationship with God, there is no fault in that. However, there is also no fault in short prayers. In Nehemiah chapter 2, verses 2 through 5, it says, "So the king said to me, 'Why is your face sad, though you are not sick? This is nothing but sadness of heart.' Then I was very much afraid. I said to the king, 'Let the king live forever. Why should my face not be sad when the city, the place of my father's tombs, lie desolate and its gates have been consumed by fire?' Then the king said to me, 'What would you request?' So I prayed to the God of heaven. I said to the king, 'If it pleases the king, and if your servant has found favor before you, send me to Judah, to the city of my father's tombs, that I may rebuild it.'" As you can see in verse 4, Nehemiah prayed. We don't know what he prayed, because it doesn't say, but we know it couldn't have been very long. Many believe he said, "Lord, help me," because he didn't want to say something wrong in front of the king. Or he could have said, "Lord, send me," since he wanted to be sent to Jerusalem to help rebuild the wall. No matter what he said, it had to be from the heart. When we are faced with this situation, we should do the same. If you need strength, pray, "Lord, give me strength." If you are dealing with a temptation, pray, "Lord, deliver me from temptation." If you are dealing with depression or grieving, pray, "Lord, teach me to rejoice in you." God listens to your prayers, no matter the length. The second thing Nehemiah did while praying is he prayed from the heart. When we pray, it should come from the heart. We don't need to think of subjects to add to our prayers to make them longer. Pray what's in your heart. In Nehemiah chapter 1, verses 2 through 5, it says, "Hananiah, one of my brothers, and some men from Judah came, and I asked them concerning the Jews who had escaped and had survived the captivity and about Jerusalem. They said to me, 'The remnant there in the province who survived the captivity are in great distress and reproach, and the wall of Jerusalem is broken down and its gates burned with fire.' When I heard these words, I sat down and wept and mourned for days, and I was fasting and praying before the God of heaven. I said, 'I beseech you, O Lord God of heaven, the great and awesome God who preserves the covenant and loving kindness for those who love him and keep his commandments.'" He goes on praying all the way to verse 11. But as you just heard, after he heard the news about the wall of Jerusalem still in shambles, he felt a great sadness. God had pressed upon his heart the motive to rebuild the wall of Jerusalem. So with this motive in his heart, he prayed to God from verse 5 to 11. When we pray, prayer must come from the heart. That's what God wants to hear. The third thing we can learn from Nehemiah's prayer life was that his first response was prayer. Nehemiah prayed first. He didn't respond then pray, he prayed then responded. We should do the same. Prayer comes first so God can answer and tell us what to do. In Nehemiah chapter 4, Nehemiah faced opposition from Samaria. It teaches that he prayed in verse 7 through 9. "Now when the Sanballat, Tobiah, the Arabs, the Ammonites, and the Ashdodites heard that the repair of the walls of Jerusalem went on and that the breaches began to be closed, they were very angry. All of them conspired together to come and fight against Jerusalem and to cause a disturbance in it. But we prayed to our God, and because of them, we set up a guard against the day and night." As you can see, Nehemiah faced oppression from the neighboring cities, but he responded in verse 13, right after praying. Then I stationed men in the lowest parts of the space behind the wall, the exposed places. And I stationed the people and the families with their swords, spears, and bows. Prayer should be our first response when we are faced with a difficult situation. Don't pray later, pray now. Those have been the three aspects of Nehemiah's prayers we can add to our prayer life that will grow our connection with God. Thank you for listening, and have a blessed day.